Each 100 MHz benchtop NMR spectrometer comes with a sample holder and depth gauge. To use, the NMR tube is placed into the sample holder and pushed to the bottom of the depth gauge. If the liquid line is barely visible at the top of the window, or not visible at all, there is sufficient volume in your sample to acquire your NMR data. Once the correct depth is reached, pick up the sample from the outside edge of the sample warmer and place it directly into the NMR spectrometer. The 100 MHz is an all-in-one instrument, meaning that the magnet, the electronics, and the computer are all included. The touchscreen is external and ergonomic, such that it can be optimized by the user. The software interface is very similar to our 60 MHz product line for those that are familiar with this. The main window has a series of quick select buttons available. The first allows the user to select the nuclei they would like to observe. This model is a proton carbon 100 Pro. For this demo video, we will acquire a proton NMR spectrum. We will lock on deuterium, as is quite standard. We have prepared this sample in deuterated chloroform, as is already selected. Each instrument has pre-configured standard experiments depending on the nuclei you have selected. We will run a 1D proton. If desired, the user can change the number of scans and start the experiment without further modification. The number of scans can be either selected from the pop-up menu, or a keyboard will appear, and the user can put in whatever custom value they desire. Prior to acquiring the data, the lock must be engaged. This is done by pressing the lock button. Prior to selecting it, you will see that it reads lock lost. The lock was disengaged when the previous sample was removed. When you select the lock button, the software automatically performs a series of frequency, phase, and power optimizations to ensure the instrument is properly locked. While this is taking place, the locking button icon will turn yellow. You will see a status on the button that reads locking, and then it will turn green and read locked. If it's desired, the experiment parameters can then be further modified. For example, spectral width can be customized by using a series of pop-up menu options, or again by selecting from the custom calculator, which will provide the min and max values available to the user. This can be done with scan delay, spectral center, number of scans, a number of points to ensure you have the desired acquisition time or time per scan. The user can select a fixed or an auto receiver gain, and the pulse angle can be modified to balance relaxation time and sensitivity. The user can modify zero fill and apodization prior to the acquisition or in post-processing as desired. Once satisfied with the experiment parameters, the user returns to the main window and selects the big green Go button. When the experiment engages, the status lights on top of the instrument will turn from green, idle, to blue, active. Once started, the spectrometer does a series of auto receiver gains. It displays the first scan and updates every additional 4 scans after that. Once the acquisition is complete, the user can change their view to observe the FID, for example. For basic processing, there are automatic or manual phase options, the data can be baseline corrected, and again, post-processing apodization and zero filling can be modified easily here. Apodization is useful to improve resolution at the expense of the noise in the baseline, or it can smooth the baseline, but it also broadens out the peaks. To see a region a little bit better, the user can select View, Horizontal Zoom, and select the bounds of the region of interest. To better analyze the data, the regions of interest can also be integrated with manual or automatic functions, and the peak picks or labels can be applied. Once the user is done, they can save the data as a screenshot, PDF, or JCAMP-DX file, locally to the computer, to a network folder, or to a USB memory stick. There are 2 easy access USB ports at the front of the instrument. Once the desired location is selected, a keyboard will pop up and the name can be modified as desired.